PGT, or pre-implantation genetic testing of embryos, requires that embryos be frozen. Most commonly, embryos are thawed one time, at the time of embryo transfer. There are situations, however, when you may want to consider thawing and freezing an embryo twice. What are those situations? Is it safe to thaw embryos more than once? What are the possible impacts? I'm IVF expert Dr. Randy Morris, MD, and this episode of Infertility TV, I will discuss some new data which may help to answer these questions. Stay tuned. Around 2009, the technology for freezing embryos changed dramatically. At that time, most IVF programs started switching from a technique called slow freezing to rapid freezing, which is also known as vitrification. The result was that a much higher percentage of embryos that were frozen would survive the thawing process. For example, at my center, IVF1, we see about 97-98% survival with vitrification. These days, thawed embryos produce pregnancies as much or more than fresh embryo transfers. As a result, many IVF programs have stopped doing fresh embryo transfers and now freeze all embryos for later transfer. Couples who intend to have PGT on their embryos must freeze the embryos after biopsy in order to allow time for the results. There are a few situations in which embryos may need to be frozen and thawed more than once. First, if a couple never had a biopsy of their embryos before freezing because they did not intend to have PGT at the time of their egg retrieval, but then later on decided that they wanted to have PGT performed. Second, in some cases, couples who intended to do PGT did not get a usable result. The couples would need to thaw their embryos, biopsy them a second time, and then refreeze. Third, couples may want to get additional information. For example, if a couple initially had PGT to determine the number of chromosomes only, this is called PGT-a, later found out that they were carriers for a specific genetic mutation. If DNA from the original sample was no longer available, they too would need to thaw their embryos, re-biopsy, and refreeze. There hasn't been a lot of study regarding embryos that have been frozen and thawed twice. The studies that we do have been mostly small and have come to different conclusions. One way to try to clarify the results when you have lots of small studies like this is to combine them into one larger study. This is called a meta-analysis. Based on this, it appears as though the survival rate the second time you thaw is the same as the first time you thaw. This is still important, however, because it means that some of the embryos that survived the first thaw may not survive the second thaw and therefore not be available for an embryo transfer. When an embryo transfer is performed with a twice-thawed embryo, the chance for implantation is the same. However, clinical pregnancy rates and live birth rates were lower. This implies that twice-thawed embryos may have a higher risk for miscarriage, and in fact, the meta-analysis also showed that miscarriage risk was higher. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this: embryos that have been frozen and thawed multiple times may have a lower chance for producing a live birth. There may be embryos that are not available for transfer because they didn't survive a second thaw, though that percentage is low. It is important to discuss these issues with your doctor to determine whether multiple embryo thaws is something that you want to do. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.